We have also identified one theme so that you learn skills to manage your projects in a better way. And that theme that we have selected is Agile methodology. When this theme was given to me, the first question that came to my mind is everyone using Agile? I'm an electronics and telecommunication engineer. Will I use this Agile, or is it only the software engineers who use the Agile? So this was the biggest question in my mind when this theme came to me. So the first thing that I did was I went to search, what is Agile? How can I use as an engineer in whatever projects that I implement? So to start with, Agile methodology talks about making and developing small changes quickly, so that it's not that you wait for long durations for the projects to complete and then think of changing the things that did not go well, but it is about making the changes as quickly as possible. As it is identified that they don't suit to the customer requirements, we can immediately change it. Therefore, it has got more flexibility in it. Learning from it, like every small change that we do or what small products that we deliver to the customer, we again go back and see what went well, what did not go well, what changes we can do the next time. So there is a lot of learnings that we need to develop after every small changes or small implementations that we did. That is what is the strength of Agile methodology. And as we learn the things, it's not that learning is only for that particular project or the part of a project. It is we need to calibrate our understanding based on what we learned so that the same problems do not occur in the future. And it is not that we do this process once in a product cycle, but we do it repetitively. It's an iterative process. And another important thing about Agile system is, or Agile methodology is, it provides you a methodology to remove an unnecessary work or cut down the waste. The waste could be in the form of knowledge goes with the person if he leaves the organization, or it is about a lot of delays in the delivery. Any other thing that may be considered as a waste. So the next thing, as I told you, was, is it only the software industry that is using? The answer is no. Agile system methodology is not only used by software, but it is used by the engineering companies, aerospace, pharmaceutical, marketing, advertising, construction companies, even planning companies, product development companies, finance related companies. All these industries use Agile methodology. So it is not limited to only the software. All the streams use this because it will improve the return of investment as well as enhance the productivity. Because your system can do early value deliveries, it can adapt with the ease, with the changes and the customer requirement. It uses all the skills of the stakeholders. It has a control over the scope. It's not that once you define the scope, it's fixed for the project. It gives you a flexibility to change the scope with the customer requirements changing. There is low risk involved because you don't come to know about the product's acceptability or usability at the end of completion of a product, but since you are making the changes quickly, so the risk of to know that the product is redundant at the end is very low. There is a lot of collaboration and communication, because of which there is a lot of transparency and understanding amongst this team. It gives you, helps you to develop a high quality product because you are using the skill of all the teams as well as the customers' involvement. So the system is sustainable, and therefore it is important to use an Agile methodology wherever we are implementing the products. Let's see what is the difference between the traditional method, the software development lifecycle I have taken, against the Agile system. So let's first see the SDLC, that is a waterfall method, where we can see the process is sequential. It's a linear stages. First is define the requirements, then develop a design, then start with the coding, then do the testing, and then implement it. There is a lot of planning and in-depth documentation involved in it. It is best only when it is simple projects and the project is not going to change. There is unchanging projects, then we can use this waterfall methodology, and a close project manager involvement. So manager is involved at every stage. Now, whereas we come to agile methodology, again, definitely it starts with the requirement collection, then preparing the plan, then we prepare the design and start developing and releasing of a minimum marketable features so that, and then tracking and monitoring it. And this is not being done for the whole project taken at a time, but the project, when the requirements are taken, we get the theme. Then that theme is divided into the user stories. And these user stories are further made into the sprints. That is a small group of work with the time box. That is 2 to 4 weeks. How much work will be completed as per the capability and capacity of the team, that this sprint is defined to fit the work in the time frame of 2 to 4 weeks. And once that is completed, that is developed, it is released, and then if the customer is accepting it, it's implemented, and then the next sprint is taken. So this is a continuous process, and in this the whole project is not taken at a time, but independent user stories which are taken, which are talking about what is the requirement. To talk about an example, let's implement an ATM system. So that may have the user stories. That is, it may have different user stories. That is, I want a cash deposit system, I want a withdrawal system, I want a check deposit system, and all that features may be defined. They are the user stories. A sprint could be a combination of one or two user stories, so that the team, as per the capacity of the team, maybe we have a team of 50 people and the capability, how much work they can do in how much work they can do in 2 to 4 weeks, that is defined, and that process is taken into consideration. So it's a continuous cycle. Small and high functioning collaborative teams are working together. It's a flexible and a continuous evaluation in the system, and there is a customer involvement in it. So here it was only the project manager's involvement was there in the waterfall method, as in this whole team along with the customer involvement is there. Summarize, traditional methodology is plan-driven, as agile is a value-driven system. So our methodology works on the agile values, which are more people-centering and result-driven as compared to the traditional methodology. Agile framework does not necessarily solve the problem, but it provides a framework, a mechanism for making the people and process problems apparent so that it can be solved. It's about problems coming out frequently and people working on it to solve it. The demands and solutions evolve through a collaborative effort of self-organizing and cross-functional teams and their customers. So it is everyone is working together along with the involvement of customer at every stage, so that we understand whether the work that is going on is in the right direction or not. So what are the different methodologies? There are Scrum, Extreme Programming, Lean, Kanban, Feature-Driven Development, Adaptive Software Development, Dynamic Software Development. Software mostly uses the Scrum, but Kanban is majorly used for the manufacturing. Lean is also one of the methodology which majorly focuses on removing the waste. That also finds its major application in the manufacturing industries. So the flow of an agile methodology is, it starts with initiating a project, understanding the theme, defining the requirement, that is defining the user stories, and dividing that user stories into the sprints, and starting with the development. So after the development of, say, the cycle of 2 to 4 weeks, the first release is ready, that is a minimum marketable feature is ready for release. Then it goes to the customer for testing, and if he accepts, then it goes for the deployment in the customer system. We don't wait for it to be completely ready for deployment. We keep on releasing the features and deploy it so that the product is actually functional in the from the beginning itself, rather than ready for use after the completion of a project, which may be a cycle of say 1 or 2 years. So if one feature is ready, that is released. One feature is released, the customer can start using it and experience the and share the feedbacks about it. And if it is not acceptable, then we have agile methodology talks about implementing the changing, adjusting and tracking and adjust and task reprioritizing. And then next iteration into the and put the next iteration into the development, and it's a continuous cycle that is going on. So this is how the user stories are. The theme is there. The major could be, as I told you, an ATM machine is to be, that could be divided into one could be for the deposit and one could be for the withdrawal. And this could be deposit, could be a check or a cash deposit, and withdrawal could be some money or getting the statements. All that, every user stories could be like, I want the reports on my dashboard. That way the things user stories can be defined, and it is divided into the sprint. So more than one user stories can be a part of a sprint. That's a small part of a project. And that can be completed into in a 2 to 4 weeks. And together, 2 or 3 user stories make one release. That is a minimum marketable feature, and it gets implemented. For an agile methodology, we need an agile team with a mindset of customer focus. As I talked about, it's a people-centric and a result-driven. So having a common goal. It has to be a team work in a cross-functional teams are working together. Collective ownership is very important. Everyone has to take the ownership of a product, positive attitude, accepting the failures and working on it again so that we are able to make the right product for the customer. There's a continuous learning after every sprint that is being made. There are meetings to understand what is the strength of the system, what went right, what went wrong, how it can be improved, how it can be accepted in the next cycle, being quality conscious, whether you are attaining the required quality as per the customer requirements, and an empowered team, the team with the required skills is always there. So that is why this is very important. These are the important qualities of an agile team that will help to adopt the agile methodology and give you the required output of high productivity and an improved return of investment. So we can say that agile methodology has got a lot of benefits, and therefore it is being adopted everywhere to have a better system. This is because it gives a visibility of what are the problems and how it can be resolved. It makes the stakeholders happy. It gives high revenue. It gives increased productivity. It gives a right product with the right quality. And it takes less time to market the product. And therefore, agile methodology has advantages which makes the system more adaptable and acceptable. If I take the example of education system, traditionally, we were teaching the students in the classroom and conducting the laboratories in the lab. But when this pandemic came, it was a problem. Either we waste the time of the students, or we adopt to this new normal and develop a system so that we are able to give the knowledge to the students even when they are at home. So that was the problem, and identifying the problem immediately, all the education systems changed to online delivery of the classroom as well as conduct of laboratory. The next part of the problem was conduct of the exam. So the online exams were conducted and the results were declared on time. So the adoption of the change helped us to make the system productive under this new normal condition, and therefore helped us to save the students' time as well as give them the degree on time. Thank you.